Hello everyone, I am Monica Bhushan and today we are starting class number 4 of Laplace transform. So in today's class we have listed down the formula which actually we have covered, right? This formula we have covered in class number 2 and this formula we have covered in class number 3. So here this is your frequency shift property where we have e raised to at multiplied with function ft. And we have seen how we have got function in frequency domain with the frequency shifted with a, this a, correct? And in last class we had seen multiply by t with any function ft. This t can be n or anything. So if it is 1, then it is minus d by ds of fs. If it is n, so in that case it will be minus 1 to the power n dn by ds n fs, correct? The function in the frequency domain. We are differentiating n number of times. Fine. So we are using these two formula in today's class to solve different type of questions. T also, e raised to at also, along with any function ft. Okay. So suppose it was just t into sine 3t, you can solve it using multiply by 3 formula. And suppose it is e raised to 2t into sine 3t, then you can use frequency shift property. But what we are going to do in the case when we have the questions where t into e raised to at into sine 3t or cos 2t or any function will be there. So we are going to see these type of questions. Because of that only we have used these two formula. Okay, so how we are going to start to solve this question? So we are going to use two steps again. Step number one will be having, see, remember that we had said that e at n, correct? If we see in Laplace transform, e raised to at, we will keep this e raised to at little aside and then we will work on anything which is other than e raised to at present. So in my case, we have t into sine 3t. So we will take ft, we will say that ft here is t into sine 3t. Okay, so and e raised to at we will work a little later. So we are going to first find out Laplace transform of t into sine 3t. So how we are going to solve it? So we had seen that if I have Laplace transform of t into ft, then what I have to do? I have to find out minus d by ds of fs. Okay, so very first thing is I have to know what is my fs, then only I'm going to differentiate it, this fs. So for that, what is other than t you have? You have sine 3t, correct? So you are going to first, you are going to find out, like in your first step, you can say that 1a. So step 1a is find out Laplace transform of sine 3t. Why? Because once we will find out Laplace transform of sine 3t, we will get the function in frequency domain. And once we will get the function in frequency domain, we will be differentiating it with negative sign. So sine 3t Laplace transform is how much? We have seen sine omega t is omega. Omega here is 3. So omega by s square plus omega square. So it is 3 square. Or you can say it is nothing but 3 by s square plus 9. Okay. Now, what is your step 1b second part? Now, whatever you have got fs, this is your fs. You just do minus d by ds of fs. Fs here is 3 by s square plus 9. Or we can write down minus 3, 3 just taken out as constant. So we are going to write d by ds of, instead of writing down 1 by s square plus 9, I am writing down s square plus 9 to the power minus 1. Because it will be easier to find out the differentiation. You know, right? What is your d by dx of x to the power n? N into x to the power n minus 1. This formula we are going to use. So, if this is what? Minus 3 into, this is my n, correct? N we are just writing down minus 1. This is my n minus 1. And then x, in this case, your x is this complete part. This is your s square plus 9, then minus 1, minus 1. And then we are using chain rule, correct? And then what we are finding out? Then we are saying what is my d by ds of s square, d by ds of s square plus 9. So it will be your minus 3 into minus 1, 3, and then s square plus 9 to the power minus 2, and d by ds of s square will be 2s plus constant, correct? Plus d by ds of 9, so constant we get, differentiation answer is 0. So we will be getting how much? We are going to get 2 into 3 into 2 is 6, 6 into s, and then this is s square plus 9 to the power minus 2, that you can say s square plus 9, this is divided by s square plus 9 square. Okay, so this much we have got. So here we got, how we have got this answer, we have just seen now. Okay, now what we are going to see? Step 1 is done. Now, we have to work on step 2. So what is my step 2? We had just now said that E at end. So now we are going to say that what will be the effect of E now. Whenever we find S, right, in numerator, denominator, everywhere, we have to shift that S with A. What is my A here? A is 2. 3 E raised to 2t. So this A is 2. So we have seen numerator also has S. So we are just shifting S by A. S minus A. A is 2. So S minus 2. Denominator again, what we are writing down? So how we are shifting the denominator? So numerator is okay, right? S minus A. A is 2. Now, what is your denominator? S square plus 9 whole square. So instead of S, first I have to shift this S and then I will square it out. So instead of writing S, I am writing down S minus 2, then whole square plus 9 and then complete whole square. Okay, so we are just saying that the numerator is 6S minus 2 and the denominator is A minus B. Whole square is A square plus B square minus 2AB. So minus 4S and then plus 9 whole square. Just simplifying it, nothing else. So the numerator becomes 6 into S minus 2. Denominator becomes S square minus 4S plus 13. So 9 plus 4, 13 and then whole square. So like how I had said in that class also, that if you have to shift S square plus 9, don't shift S square, don't shift S square minus 2 plus 9. This is wrong. What we have to say, that S minus 2 first shift, then make it a square and then write down plus 9 and then it is whole square. Okay, this is the result of E raised to 80, which we had done, which we had said that E attained. Okay, so this is our final answer. Similarly, if you will see the second question, exactly same fashion. This type of question, if you are going to see that T is also present, T can be T raised to N, T can be 1, 2, 3, 4, anything. So accordingly, we have to differentiate those many number of times. So this is T to the power 1 only. So T into E raised to 80 is also there, and some any other function which is in T domain is there. So what should come in your mind? E at end. That means I'll just keep this E a little aside, and whatever is there other than your E raised to 3t, E raised to minus 3t will be my function, right? So t into cos 2t. Again, this is my first step, but this first step also needs two steps, right? So very first thing is we have to come into frequency domain. So we have to first find out what is my Laplace transform of cos 2t. So Laplace transform of cos 2t is S will be on the numerator and the denominator will be having S square plus omega square. Omega here is 2, so 2 square. So it will be your S by S square plus 4. Now we have, so this is what we have come into frequency domain. Now what is Laplace transform of T into FT? Correct, T into FT, it is nothing but minus D by DS of FS. So my Fs is S by S square plus 4. So we will be saying it minus is here only. So we are going to say D by DS of the general form I'm just writing. This is your D by DX of U by V. V into D by DX of U minus U into D by DX of V. And then this is complete numerator divided by V square. So same thing if I'm writing down here. So it is minus I'm just taking out. And then this is your V. V is S square plus 4. And then D by DS of S minus your U is S. And then D by DS of V. v is s square plus 4. Then after that you are going to say this is divided by s square plus 4 whole square. Now what we have to do? S square plus 4 and then d by ds of s will give you 1. So minus s, then d by ds of s square is how much? 2s plus d by ds of constant is how much? 0. And then divided by s square plus 4 whole square. So your numerator is nothing but s square plus 4 minus 2s square, and the denominator is s square plus 4 whole square. So finally this minus also we are considering, and then it will be your s square, then minus 4, s square minus 4, and then divided by s square plus 4 whole square. So if you will see, yes, we have also got the same answer. Fine. So we are done with our first step. So first step is done, that we got that t into ft. Finally, we are going to deal with e raised to at. So how we are going to do? So this step is quite easy, correct? What we have to do? Just wherever you find, finally you are finding s everywhere, right? So wherever you are finding s, just shift it. So shift this s, you shift this s with this a. What is a here? Minus 3. So instead of writing this line, you have to write s minus of minus 3, s minus a. And then it is whole square minus 4. This line only I am writing down with the effect of e raised to, minus 3t. Then divided by s square. What is s? First you have to shift s minus of a. So minus of minus 3. And then this is your whole square. Then plus 4 and complete got power 2. So the numerator is s plus 3 whole square minus 4. Denominator is s plus 3 whole square plus 4, and then finally whole square. So this line we also have got the same thing, correct? So after that, what we are doing? A plus b whole square formula. A square plus b square plus 2ab, then minus 4, and finally here also we are simplifying. A plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab, and then plus 4, and then we got. So this is your final answer. So the two steps we have to follow to get the answer of this type of questions. So if you find this class useful, please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.